6:45 in Trinidad and Tobago. Well, it's a measure how ignorance causes people to get tizzy, because last week the unemployment figure stood at 4%, which, according to global statistics, is considered full employment. Because early 2004, 2005, we were just around that figure. Prime Minister Manning talked about it at the time that we were close to 5%. But now, because it's gone up towards 4%, you're getting the sort of reaction as if already the sky is falling, which again reinforced what I said at the top of the show, that most people have no idea what to do to deal with the current economic circumstances. And it's often said that it is the best time, however, to start a business. But how do you start a business when you have little to no money or have just been laid off? Well, that is the question that we hope to get some answers from our next guest. These are some of the topics that the Cash Flow Club TNT tackles in their six-week simulation-based course. Well, I'm set to give you some tips on how you can start up your business despite the economic climate. We have, should I say, the James Bond of making money, because he's Roger Moore. His father is a Roger Moore. Clearly, his father is a big, big fan of the James Bond character, Roger Moore, specifically, not Sean Connery or anybody else after. But Roger Moore, the 14th, I suppose. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good to have you
on
the show.
Yes.
I should mention that we'll be taking some calls right after the news at 7 o'clock. If you have any specific questions to Roger about this, is it a get-rich-quick-fix something? Is it a gimmick? Is it that he's running off to the Bahamas with the money afterwards or whatever? But before we speculate wildly, what is this all about? What is this Cash Flow Club TNT and the courses that are offered? What's it all about?
All right, perfect. All right, thanks, Vazir. Okay, so this here is a book called Rich Dad, Poor Dad. The tagline for the book is What the Rich Teach Their Kids About Money That the Poor and Middle Class Do Not. This book became a 6-time New York Times bestseller. And it's a book
on there's a way to make money, to make people feel that you have a book that will make you money.
Well, this book is sold in all the bookstores in the country. So when you buy it, you're making them rich, not me.
Right. Okay.
Right. So this is for your own financial education. But what people don't know is that this is also an entrepreneurship book. You have to teach entrepreneurship with finance, because finance is the language of business. And as we always say at Cash Flow Club, it is actually a crime against humanity not to teach people about money in the school system. Because our school system doesn't teach that, and people struggle financially all their lives, whether there's a recession or not.
And okay, so let's talk specifically about this Cash Flow Club. I'm sure many people would have heard of it already, but just give us some idea as to what this program is all about.
Okay, so Cash Flow Club is a business school invented by Robert Kiyosaki. It's simulation-based. Because when you use simulations...
So this is the Trinidad and Tobago chapter?
This is the Trinidad and Tobago chapter.
Right.
We have been around
for the head of that organization.
Of course, yeah. We have been around for almost 12 years now. The first 4 years, we ran free sessions every single weekend because we realized this thing was working on people. It teaches people how to invest in real estate, businesses, and paper assets, whether it's a recession or not. And in fact, it goes into so much detail. We've been able to teach people how to raise capital for their businesses and investments. So it's the ultimate game changer. Lots of people leave their jobs while doing the course and that kind of thing because of the information that it gives. We usually say that GOB in Cash Flow Club, GOB stands for Just Over Broke, because you'll be surprised, lots of people, actually the vast majority of people, struggle financially even if they have a good job. But what's risky is just having one source of income, that being a salary. That's a very, very risky way to live.
Why is it risky? Because if you manage things effectively, if you live within your means,
if you lose that one source of income, most people last 3 months before they get thrust into poverty. You know, just recently, some people in the media got laid off. About 33 workers got laid off last week.
Yes,
they no longer have a source of income. So people always ask me, you know, Raj, you know, investing is risky. Investing is risky. But what's really risky is just having one source of income. Because when you lose that one source of income, that's it. You're in trouble.
So what are you offering? What is Cash Flow Club? Because to tell you the truth, Roger, Cash Flow Club TNT sound like one of those things where that you see the name American ads and so on. Just do this, that, and the other, and you're going to make $20 million
right.
in next to no
so it's
time.
Not a
get and rich, it's a gimmick.
It's not a get-rich-quick scheme. It is financial education. And remember, our education system is designed to produce employees. It's not designed to produce business owners and investors. So in a climate that we have now, thousands of graduates.
What
are
the S's for? You talk about the EDB and the
I. S is for self-employed. A lot of people become self-employed where they're in their own private practice as lawyers, doctors, and accountants. They get stuck in the rat race. These guys are stuck in the rat race. The rat race is your dependence on a salary. And the whole point of Cash Club is to educate people to get off of that dependence on a salary so they can become business owners and investors. So even if you're still an employee, you could invest in real estate. You could be an employee and have investments in a business on the side, right? So a recession doesn't stop that. A recession actually creates more opportunity.
How do I do that? If it is that, as you say, if I'm in the riskiest situation of just having one source of income through employment, but that source of income I can just get by. Where am I getting the extra money to invest or to speculate?
And this is where our education comes in. So I'll show you some of the books that we have. Now, we don't sell books. The bookstore sells the books. Amazon.com sells the books, right? We have one here called Other People's Money, how to raise capital for investments. Most people don't start businesses simply because they can't afford it, but they don't know that you can raise capital. So we actually help our entrepreneurs raise capital. We have several different ways. We send them to Youth Business. We send them to the show Planting Seeds. I don't want to say what station, and we help them raise capital. In fact, with simulations, they practice raising capital over and over and over again to get it right before they do it in real life.
Other People's Money?
Other People's Money. This is just one of them.
That sounds like a book for government minister because they're very good at wasting other people's money.
And I'm not a politician, so I'm not here to rally or to, get people's attention in this late stage. I didn't even know that was the Minister of Education. I never saw him before in my life. But we have been working so hard since the recession started. We've been working 7 days a week because people, when they see a recession, they come to Cash Club to learn as much as they can because they realize they're just sitting ducks.
And is it that therefore they are doomed to fail because they have not even taken into consideration? They are looking for you to rescue them. They are looking for other organizations to rescue them when they fail to heed the warning signs on their own. So of what point is all of this to them? Because they're probably thinking that just because they come to your course and sign up for it and so on, at the end of it all, it will just be money flowing in.
The first major step everybody has to take is educating themselves. This is their first major investment. You have to invest in your own financial education.
You're going to get a little commission for selling a book or something?
No, this is why I do free talks all over the country. I did a free talk yesterday at Doxa. Last week I was in Tobago. We give free business and financial advice because people desperately need it. And there's a movement on Facebook right now to get us into the schools to teach students. We have a strict 18 years and over policy simply because kids are very intelligent and they apply what they learn very quickly. And they go make money in school and they get themselves into a lot of trouble.
But is it that effective, this six-week course? Has it been proven to deliver on what it promises?
We have trained thousands of people and we have a lot of success stories, hundreds of success stories. It is almost impossible not to take action when you use simulations. Every human being is a genius. And we have something called the cone of learning.
Yeah, we have it on the screen. Explain what it is we're looking
this
at.
This shows the most effective ways to learn. And you realize on the bottom of the cone it's called reading. We can't really see it there, but yeah. It is actually one of the worst.
There's something a bit further down that talks about reading. Yeah.
It is actually one of the worst ways to learn. The second worst way to learn is just hearing words. You hear 20% of what you hear. And this is where our education system is based. You go to class, you listen to lecture, you read the textbook, cram for the exam the night before, and then forget everything after. That's not very effective. So what we do now is simulating a real experience, which is the second best way to learn. So we have Cash Club, which is a business school, teaching people how to get out of the rat race and protect themselves so that if they lose their jobs, they don't go broke. And we also just launched a new project called Mad Science, and that is the world's number one science enrichment company. And again, they use simulations to teach science and engineering, and that is growing exponentially in the primary schools and high schools. In fact, our program is for the primary schools, and the high schools are demanding it. Last week, we trained St. Benedict's College, for example.
And what has been the reaction that you, when people attend, what sort of questions are raised? Are people looking for the quick fix? Are people appreciating that they need to get better educated in the business of economics and finance to really be able to have that solid footing of education?
Yes, they take action almost immediately. In fact, we try to get people not to take action while the course is going on. So one of our challenges is actually getting people not to leave their jobs while the course is going on, and people disobey.
It happens pretty often. So great that people decide that they're going to leave their jobs and
some people do, yeah. Some people take the leap one time. In fact, the most important skill they have to learn even after cash flow is learning how to sell. That is number one, the number one skill to learn, because sales equals income. And, you know, they go off there and they learn to sell. The best way to learn to sell, of course, is doing the real thing, which is one cone of learning. That's the best way to learn. Second best way, is to do simulations of the real experience, like sales courses that are practical and hands-on. Dale Carnegie has a sales course, which is really good. And we have a new entrepreneur with a sales program called Upsell that is also getting a lot of attention. They're all practical, hands-on. They do a lot of role-playing to teach people how to sell, which is the number one skill.
While we continue our discussion, Roger, if somebody decides, okay, I'm on board. I want to be part of this. What do I have to do if I want to sign up for the 6-week course, for the next round of lectures or whatever it is? What do I have to do?
Just give me a call at 768-6761.
768-6761.
Yeah. Give me a call or message me on Facebook. I have Roger Moore on Facebook or Cashflow Clubs TNT on Facebook. Just sign up. We have a lot of courses on the way. We have one starting.
Are they ongoing? Is it something that they have to wait for a particular cycle?
Since this recession, it's constantly ongoing. We have a big class on Wednesday at Valpark Shopping Plaza. We have a class graduating today, this evening. We have a next course starting on Sunday coming. Based on demand, we might invite more people to join and do courses. We're looking at Tuesdays and Thursdays next month to start more courses because people are tracking us down from all over the country. Every time there's some sort of downturn, our phone starts to ring pretty often, 7 days a week. We work nonstop.
And what are you producing at the end? And by the way, what's the cost of
the cost? The cost is actually structured for everybody to afford. So it's $1,000 for all 6 weeks.
Right.
Well, $9.99.
Yeah.
We give them their dollar change.
Some salesman again. You don't want to show them the $1,000.
Yeah.
$9.99.
Yeah.
To hide the zeros.
And they learn everything from real estate investing to investing in stocks, which by the way is you have to invest during a recession is buy low, sell high.
Yeah.
They learn how to invest in businesses. They learn how to grow businesses. They learn things like, how to buy and sell a business. They learn how to, the ABCs of real estate investing. They learn all these very valuable skills that is not taught in the education system. And we have a very big problem with that. We think that is a crime against humanity.
Well, I doubt you'll get a chance to talk to the minister, seeing that he was the next time, and then he might identify him or recognize him. But we're going to take a break because we have to pause for the news. When we come back, we'll spend a few minutes more with Roger Moore of Cashflow Club TNT. And you can call in with your questions, your issues in relation to the money worries that many of us are experiencing now in Trinidad and Tobago. Time for the news, and then we'll continue our discussion with your calls.